being recorded.
Hello, good afternoon to one and all person here. Hello. Good afternoon to one and all person here. I invite Dr. R. Professor Mechanical Engineering Department. KSR Institute for Engineering and Technology. Tamil Nadu. To introduce our chief guest, Mr. K. Shain, Assistant Professor Mechanical Engineering, MES College of Engineering, Kerala. Invite you, sir.
Welcome, Mr. Shain, sir. Assistant Professor Mechanical Engineering, MES College of Engineering, Kerala. Once again, I warm welcome and also to introduce Mr. Shain, sir. Professor Shain, K. Assistant Professor, Mechanical Department of MES College of Engineering, Kuttipuram, Kerala. He did B.Tech in Mechanical Engineering from NSS College of Engineering, Palakkad. And also, he did M.Tech in CAD and Analysis from MIT, Manipal. Currently, doing PhD in Welding Metallurgy from Anna University, Chennai. Underwent 1 month intensive training in FAP Lab at Trivandrum, a venture in collaboration with MIT, US. In addition to academic, I am serving as FAP Lab Manager at MES College. And also, I am a mentor of Atal Innovation Mission. And also conducted and handled sessions in various FDs, FD, PBS, and digital fabrication technology, and design and 3D printing areas. I warm welcome for the today's session, 14th session. He handled a topic, different materials used in 3D printing, slicing area to handle it. So now it's to hand over the session 14, Mr. K. Shain, sir. Welcome, once again, I warm welcome to hand over the session now. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, everybody. So I will be basically concentrating on 3D slicing software and a little knowledge on the I will give information on materials. So I will be concentrating more on the 3D slicing software. That is what we are, what I am going to tell about is about Cura software. Okay, so I'm moving on to my PowerPoint presentation. If you feel any difficulty, you just tell me, or else you can ask in between. Okay. I hope you can see the PowerPoint.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. And my voice is on volume.
Okay, sir.
So basically, these are 3D printing materials. So before going to 3D printing materials, I will be moving on to 3D slicing software. So the slicing software, 3D slicing software. So in the last session, you have, the sir has gone through different formats which are used for 3D printing, like STL, OBJ, etc., etc. So after that, after some CAD design and after transforming into STL files, what we have to do? That is what the part I am covering, because this STL file, it cannot be directly fed into the 3D printing machine. Before that, we need to convert it to G codes, which is a machine language for CNC machines. And basically 3D printing machine is a CNC machine. So that part, that gap filling is done by this software Cura 3D slicing software. So these are the points which I am going to deal with: importing a model, orientation, nozzle size, build plate addition, infill support, all these things, and some last three topics that is something extended. I will give some extended knowledge on shrinkage, retraction, and elephant foot compensation. So, this is a software, what is called as Cura, and it is that software is given by Ultimaker company. So, someone who knows 3D printer surely know this Ultimaker, because they are the community in US. They are actually the first community who is developing different types of 3D printing machines. So they have developed this Cura software, and this is 3.1.1 version. So you can see a box here. So this is what the Ultimaker provided 3D printer, and what this 3D printer is, the theory behind this is FDM only. So you might have gone through different various techniques like selective laser sintering, then poly jet printing, etc., etc. So here what we are concentrating on is FDM, that is fused deposition modeling. So initially we need to make a CAD model, and after making that CAD model, we have to convert that into STL file. STL means stereolithography files. Okay, so I have already made a model here. So first one we need to do is file, open file. Similar to any of the of this. So you can see here .stl file. So this STL file is made from a 3D modeling software that is Rhino, and after making it in Rhino, I have converted into STL. Now you can see a pawn. This is actually coin of the chessboard. This is a pawn. So what you can see is a pawn. Now I am going to give you the settings. Okay. So once the right hand side, you can see a panel here, and here the top of the screen you can see views. This is a solid view. So once you click on this thing, you can see the dimension. Like it is having 29.5 mm, 16.25 in Y, 16.25 in Z direction, and here color X, Y, Z, that is actually indicating this thing. This is X, and Y you are Y this direction, and Z that is blue direction. Okay, so once you click on the model, these things will be highlighted. Now, initially this will be placed at the center. If you are having more number of elements to print, so you can move or place it. So that is the option here, move. You can move. Now this is at 000 location of the 3D printer, that is at the center. If you are moving along X, you can give some value, that is 10, it moves. If you want to move in Z Y direction again, okay. So now I am going to keep it in 000 only. Any difficulty you can ask me in between, no problem. So next thing is scaling the model. So what we are having is 29.5, 16.25 and 16.25, that is 100%. So there are two type of scaling. So first one is uniform scaling. Uniform scaling means if I am making it to 200, that is double, it will become double the size. And since I have checked uniform scaling, this 200 will be taken care of Y and both Y and Z. You can see the size is increased. Now the dimension has changed to double, 59, 32.5, 32.5. Okay, so I am again converting that into 100. Now see what happens if I am unchecking this uniform scaling. I am made to 200. This changes, what will happen? Only X direction it will move double. Now see, along X direction it has elongated. So this is not what we actually repair. We repair this thing 100 only. So next option, that is rotate. You can rotate this along x direction, along y direction, z direction. So now I am placed it this way. So you can see some gaps, because since it is not a parallel, not parallel object, you can see gaps between the object and the or the element to be printed and the 3D printer plate. This grid is showing the 3D printer plate. Okay. So in order to avoid that, we can rotate it like this. So at this position, it is inclined. Okay, so it is very difficult to print actually, because the below portion, that is actually not parallel to the surface. So here we need to give supports. For that, we move this one, lay flat. Now it has become flat. Okay. So for better viewing, I am increasing the size. Otherwise, it will be difficult. Now it has become big. Okay. Now next option is mirror. Mirror, you can do mirror. So in this case, since it is symmetric, we can't see any effect. But if that is not symmetric, means we can see surely it will mirror. Okay. So here you are watching this solid view. Instead of viewing solidly, we can change it either to X-ray mode. This is X-ray mode, or the most useful, layer view. Okay, so this is the layer view. So what we need to do is, this is, since this is STL, we have to slice it, because 3D printer, the material is like, you know, the material is printed in a layer by layer. So all the, how many layers we need to set, what is a layer height, layer width, then printing speed, everything we need to set. So this is by default, it is showing as 393 layers. You can see 393 here, 393 layers. So we are moving, means you can see, this is, you can, you please look at the model. Here, this is the 393th layer. So I am just moving to 305. You can see that layer, 305. Again, it is going down. And this is the first layer. Okay. So the, like that we can view. So this is a better, better structures. Instead of viewing it solid, we can view layers. Now, also if I can place it 175, if I play this, you can watch. You can see it is printing from 175th layer. It starts printing. You can see some yellow tool is moving. Whether you can see, anyone please? Anyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So you can see green layers now. So what green is representing? You can see here, this is inner wall. So it is showing inner walls. Red means shell. Shell means outside. Then this yellow means infill, that I will go through later. Okay. So you can see. So I will just move it fast. Next layer, layer by layer, it is showing. Okay. Now, here, here you can see the dimension. Okay, see, this is Ultimaker 2 Plus machine. So this is the dimension what we are having, 32.7 into 32.6 into 59. Okay. Now we can see here, the time taken. I think one of the delegates has asked how to set timing and all. So this is by default, it is 1 hour, 4 minutes. And the total length of the material will be 1.38 meter. And the total weight will be 10 gram. Everything will be calculated based on the, and this you can see time specification, this infill 12%. So it will take 12% time for filling infill. All those things are highlighted in the blue. So these things are all recommended by the software only, but we can customize it. So better, if you are a good designer, not like that. If you are a mechanical engineer, you should always don't rely on recommended settings. We should always improvise. Okay. So next, going on to these panels. So first one is material. So what I am going to do is I am using PLA material. PLA means polylactic acid material. And there are so many other materials which I have on the slides with me. If time permits, I can share you some of the material details. This is ABS, then nylon, polycarbonate, polypropylene. This is a new material, TPU-95A. And Ultimaker has planned for many new materials which are suitable to PLA, or which are suitable to this 3D printing. So what I am having here is PLA, that is polylactic acid. And you can see the nozzle size. We are the common general specification for the nozzle is 0.25, 0.4, 0.6 and 0.8. So 0.25 mm, if you are using the nozzle, means through the nozzle, the material is oozing out from the fused state. Okay. So the nozzle, if it is fine, that is 0.25, if we need fine layers, then we should go for 0.25. But we are concentrating on some other thing like mechanical strength, etc., etc. We should go for other layers. So what I have put in my 3D printer, that is 0.6 mm. So that's why it is given as 0.6 mm. I can change that, no problem. So I'm changing that to 0.25. Certainly what happens, the time will increase. You can see, just change, just calculating, slicing. You can see below, it is slicing. And now see the change. 6 hours. See, it will take 6 hours. Earlier it was only 1 hour. So now I am using what? 0.25 mm. Okay, so in the case of this chess coin and all, no problem. You can use 0.8. We need only that material. Not strength is not that much consideration. Okay. Now, coming on to next case, this is recommended. Okay, so if you click recommended, the options are very less. See here, custom, there are lot and lot of options. So recommended means this is recommended by software only. And first thing we can see is layer height. So the layer height has very great importance in setting the design. So what layer height means? Here you are seeing 294 layers, that is from the below, from the bottom of the model till the top, we have 294 layers of 3D printing materials. So this printer is going to create 294 layers. And the size will be 0.2 of each. Like that the calculation goes. So 0.2 layer height size, that into the total size, that is 32.7x 32.6y 59. So total height is calculated accordingly. Now you can see infill details. This is 20 30 40 50 60, like that. 100% infill means your material or the 3D printed model will be fully solid inside, that is density will be more. And if you are infilling, that 90% means 10% will be void inside. Because if you need more strength, your infill should be 100%. And if you need less strength, your infill should be lower. So there is a condition for filling infill that I will show you in PPT. It's not like blah, blah, that is 20%, 30%. Not like that. There are some certain conditions under which we change the infill percentage. So you can see this also, this is only 41 minutes. And if you are increasing, maybe this slightly increase, 53. So it is 70%. Now from 41 minutes, it has changed to 53. So by default, it has given 20%. Okay. Now, the very next point is, you can see blue layer over here. Red is outer shell. You can see green, that is green and yellow, that is inside. Infill and inside walls. So here blue. What this blue represents? Because this is directly, it is going to print on the printer bed. So there are some problems like it won't be that much melt or cool. So that sometimes the material may slip from the basement or bed, what you call. Okay, so in order to avoid those things, we give them build plate additions. Okay. Build plate addition means there are three types of build plate additions, that is brim, raft and skirt. That means if you are having small the one, the model which is placed in the bed is having that much precise. So after the 3D printing, if you are taking it out, there may be tear and wear and tear for the model. If you are pulling or something, trying to move it out. So in order to avoid that, we are giving build plate addition to the model. Okay, that I will give you in detail. So next case is generate support. Generate support means you can see this layer. You can see this layer is actually, what do you call, it's actually shown overhanging. Overhanging this one. And here also some overhanging. Here also some overhanging. So how to print it? These overhanging structures cannot be printed as such because the layer will fall down because of gravity. So in order to print those overhanging structure, we need to give supports. So support also, so if you click here support, but here actually the model does not require support since there are some conditions for giving supports. That condition also I will tell you. If you are giving support means it may take some more time for printing. 52 minutes. See, test it. So now I am removing that. Now, 1 second. So this is what I told you as build plate addition. So build plate addition is a must because you can see this is the model. This red part is a model. So this red part after finishing or after completing the 3D printing, we can't pull it out directly because it is already added to the bed. Okay, so in order to avoid that condition, what we give is first option is rafting. Rafting means we are initially, the first layer will be printed in such a way that we won't print the element or the model. We will print the first layer of the mesh. That is, you can see it in blue. And above that only, we will 3D print the required model. So after printing, what we can do is we can pull that blue layers out so that the plate will be safe and also your model will be safe. Okay, I hope you understand what is rafting. Because these things, usually what I saw is, in the case of 3D printing, the beginners will do is simply follow the recommended this thing. But so many problems will come in between. You can download many STL files from internet like Pinterest, then 3dp.com. So many sites are giving STL files. But they won't recommend you what is raft or what is brim, etc. So that is your own idea of giving what should be given, whether you should give raft, whether you should give brim, etc., etc. Okay, so that I will show you. So what I am planning is I will show some practical this thing instead of giving a lecture on Qura. It will be useful to you. Okay, so see, this is a simple rocket model. So here also it is given, because since you can see there are some benefits. First one is warping. Warping means what is called warping? Warping means there will be a slight slanting. If it is more like vertical model, there will be some slanting from the bottom layer to top layer. There will be some slanting because of the three conditions. First one is the plate should be plane. All ends, it is a square plate, and you know that there are four corners, so that the four corners should be in a plane, or it should be in level. Otherwise, there should be some warping will occur. Okay, so in order to avoid that warping, we'll go for this rafting. So here you can see what is rafting. This is three. These three blue colors where this rocket is going to touch the build plate. Next one is greater bed addition. So this part is bed. So it is giving greater the addition to the bed, so that while printing these sharp corners, it will be helpful. Otherwise, the sharp corners will be tear out. So next one is tiny legs. Obviously, that is there. Tiny legs. In order to support that, you should give the raft. So next option is brim. You can see the blue layer over here. See, just outside blue layer. So this is what is called as brim. So brim is something different. Like, it is not printing the first layer. So brim means it is printed only on the outside. So initially the brim will be printed like raft, but it is printed only outside, so that this brim, if you pull the brim out, along with that brim, you can pull out your motor. So here it is shown, only attached to the outer edges of the print and not beneath it like a raft. So it also helps in bed addition and prevent warping. Okay, so next thing is the difference between brim and raft. You can see one frog sitting here. So brim is placed outside like this, but about rafting, it is placed below the mold. You can see thick layers over here. This is raft, and there we can see thin layers outside. This is what is called as brim. So next one is skirting. For skirting, it's only a single layer is printed outside. Can anyone tell what is the peculiarity of skirting? Why skirt is needed? Because it is nowhere connected with your model. Then what is the help of skirting? So brim and raft, it is connected to the model so that you can pull it out easily. But what about skirting? Nowhere in connection with the model. So when you pull that skirt out, then you will get only skirt, which is waste only. So what may be the function of skirt? Skirt means this will be printed initially as brim and raft. The skirt is also printed initially. So the main thing is we are having different PLA material, so that we don't know whether that PLA, generally the temperature what we use is 220 degree or 230 degree, but some material may be some infill, that pores or voids or something will be there in material. So if it is heated to that temperature, we need to check whether the material is coming out smoothly or whether the material is having any problem. So if you are directly printing that 3D print what we need, then what happens? Your initial material will be lost because of incorrect material feeding and all. Okay, so it's skirt is used as a check. So if you print the layer, if you can see whether the skirt is okay, and if the skirt is not okay, you can abolish your print. If the skirt is okay, you can continue. So this is what is called as skirt. If you are concentrating on, if you are using a very costly material, the skirt will be very helpful. Okay. Now this is just an example. You can see the difference between skirting and brim. So the outer one is skirt. See, outer one is skirt. You can give both skirt and brim, and this is brim. And if it is a raft, you can see material over here also, if it is a raft. Okay. So this is the main difference between skirt, brim and raft. Now, I told you already about the infill. Infill means the material which is printed inside of the material. We can keep it as hollow or we can fill it like the shown structures. These each infill pattern has their own significance. It is not like, if you see, we can say it is something design, symbol patterns, craftwork or something, but it is not actually really that one. Each and every infill pattern is having its own significance. Okay, so first one, the lines and zigzag. If you use lines and zigzag patterns, it is having low strength. So for low strength material, low strength product, if you need 3D prints for low strength product, you should go for lines and zigzag ones. There is no need of other thing. And if you are using for medium strength, then grid, triangles, trihexagonal. And if you are going for high strength, you can give cubic, cubic subdivision, octet, etc. Gyroid. And if you are giving for flexible 3D prints, you should go for concentric cross 3D. So some of the examples, this is real-time example. You can see this is used lines or zigzag because it is lightweight, so that here it is lines or zigzag infill patterns, and typical infill density is 0 to 15%. This you will get in guides. You can search for Ultimaker guide, 3D printing guides, it is there. These all things we usually neglect because it is already there in your recommended structure, but you should be aware of this because what we expect is they are having their own material. That is purely your, pardon? That is actually US made materials. We won't get the correct material in India. Pardon? Any problem? Okay, I can't hear you properly. Okay, now it's audible. Tell me.
एमएट करवाना है ना
यू कैन आस्क इन चैट आफ्टरवर्ड्स ओके
साउंड टाउन एक करवाना पण एक एक लेक्चर ओढेर टम टम करिए तो
हेलो
जो तुम्हें जो पांच लेक्चर छे ने तुम्हें पांच लेक्चर छे ने बराबर जेम से टेमेट रह दियो बराबर
सर आई थिंक ही इज ऑन कॉल
ठीक है थोड़े डेवलप
ओके 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 आई थॉट ही वाज आस्किंग सम डाउट्स
अगर हमारो सेट थे जा हम कहीं चेंज
Okay, so you can see the other structure. This is triangle and trihexagonal grids, which is suitable for medium strength materials and typical infill density, that is 15 to 50%. I will share this PPT to you so that you can check. Okay, so next that is functional 3D prints. This is a hinge, so or bracket. So the infill density should be more because it is more dependent on the mechanical strength. So that is 50%. And the shape which is suitable is tetrahedral infill and pyramid stacks. now water cubic, and this is a new shape which is developed, gyroid. You can see a new shape here, over here. This is developed by, I think it's developed by these 3D printing people only. A unique pattern. And I think this Ultimaker company has developed a new material also. So next, the flexible 3D prints. You can see this flexible wrench over there. And in that case, can use concentric cross and cross 3D materials. And typical density, you can see 0 to 100%. What does this mean? 0 to 100% means everyone can give 0 to 100%. That is sure. But it all depends on the strength what we require. User himself should decide. So the next one is support structures for overhangs. What I showed earlier. So see, if the structure is like Y, H, and this thing, this is T, you can see the overhangs, how to print these overhangs. Till this part, it is okay. It will print directly, whatever this, this part is printed in air. How can it be placed? So the, this is difficult. Here, this, these two legs, it is easy, but what about this middle portion? And this T's. These two overhangs. You can see here. In building plate, there are two options, touching build plate, and you should give support everywhere. So this thing, it has given everywhere. So that this is the overhanging part. Here also, this is the overhanging part. But support is given everywhere. See, wide portion. Even here, it is given some supports. But in this case, instead of giving everywhere, it's touching build plate only. So you can see this one. It is supported by these two layers. And these two layers is supporting. So in the case of support structures, you can either go for any one option. One is touching build plate and one other one is everywhere. And this is the thumb rule. Okay. So this is having 45 degree models. So here you can see red. If and the red color shows, here the red color shows your overhang requires support. That's what this red color is showing. So in some of the models, if you model it and convert it to STL, and afterwards if you put it in Cura software, it will be showing some red portion. So if it is overhang, surely it indicates that that overhanging structure needs support. So here, surely you should give some support. See, this is support. Okay, so here the 45 degree. So there's a clear cut rule that 0 to 45 degree, usually the 3D printer will take care of. There, it doesn't require any. This 30 degree, 45 degree, doesn't require any support, because they will place layer as first layer will be placed in this way. The speed will be decreased so that this end can support this layer end. Like that, there is an option in 3D printing. So till 45, you don't require any support, and afterwards you require support. That is thumb rule, but practically you should give some from 30 to 45 also. Sometime it may require what you call support. So these are some of the support patterns. You can see support patterns. Okay. So at this point, I am again moving on to Cura software. Okay. So generate support, build plate edition. These two I have shown here. Now I am changing these settings from recommended to custom. So recommended to custom, first thing you can see is quality, that is layer height. Layer height is 0.2. 0.2, if you click here, the explanation will be given there in blue. The height of each layer in mm. Higher values produce faster prints, and it will be the resolution will be obviously less, but lower values will produce slower print in higher resolution. Okay. And if you are giving layer height then it will affect all layers. This thing you can see top layers, bottom layers, infill layer thickness, etc. will be taken care of by this layer height. So each layer will be having 0.2, and if you can change that, you want to change, you can change it to 0.5. Sorry, this is 0.5. Let's change it to 17 minute, and if it is 1 mm, let's change it to 9 minutes. So what you can see is, if you increase the layer height, the number of layers will be reduced. Obviously, the number of layers will be reduced. See here, 60. We started with, I think, 240 or something. Okay. So this all depends on the designer, how much you have to give. Depends on your model. Next part is wall thickness. Wall thickness means shell. You can see the shell, outer shell. So the shell thickness means there are two types of shells. One is outer shell, and top and bottom they are going to make shell in order to give some strength to the model. Top and layers will be given shell so that you can give wall thickness. You can either increase the wall thickness or decrease the wall thickness. Now this is infill density. Now it is given as 20. You can increase it to 100. Infill pattern, what I gave is lines. You can change it to triangle so that you can see the inside. How to watch this? You can see. Now 587 layers. And increase this one layer. See, now you can watch. First one is blue layer is going to print here. Simulation. What is that blue layer? That is brim only. Okay. And it is printed till that material. You can see 2, 3. See, till this it is printing. Now it started to print green color. That means it is creating infills. Okay, green means inner walls. Now see. Now this is yellow means infill. Green means inner wall. Yellow means infill. You can see the infill. It is getting more and more. See. Okay. You can change this to any zigzag. Now the pattern will change. Okay. So this time also it has changed to 2 hours 43 minutes just because infill density is 100. I'm again changing to 20. Now, the next thing is material retraction. What is the material retraction? So here you can see the retraction. You can see two models. What is the difference? So the top, these cylindrical layers will be printed in such a way that the 3D printer nozzle will move like this. Afterwards, it will go to print this thing. Again, it moves up, goes this way, retract. Again, print, goes this way, retract. So every time, it is taken along with that nozzle, something is printed here. Okay. So you know, we need to avoid those things. Because if a tool is moving, that is moving along with the fused material. Okay. So in order to avoid those things, we should give retraction. And we will get a good print. Otherwise, your print will be not that good. That is what is called as retraction. So enable retraction. Here not needed. Next speed you can change, print speed, that is 40, travel speed, that is 120. Print speed is the speed at which printing happens, and it affects here fan speed is also necessary because the cooling effect is given by fan. Then only your fused material is going to become solid. Next, travel speed. Travel speed is speed at which this moves. In addition to that printing speed, this travel speed means tool moves, no? That is the travel speed. So next, already I dealt with generate support, all those things. So there are many other options, which since the time permitted is less, I can't show you more. Okay. So after this, what we need to do is we save the file, save to file. This is given as UM2 plus, means Ultimaker 2 plus pons.gcode. So we have generated gcode, which is necessary for the 3D printer to. I'm saving that. Now, this thing, you save it in any pen drive, and you can directly give it to the 3D printer for printing. Okay. So one more thing I have to share with you is the next problem which you are facing is this thing, elephant foot compensation. What that means is, if you are given brim, everything will be given. Then also there are slight, you can see this more or less discharge from the bed. You can see slight variation here. It's looking like elephant, elephant foot. That's why it is called as elephant foot. Okay, this model also you can see something here. You can see small gap, which is not suitable for your model if it is used for structures. This happens because of insufficient cooling, or what do you say, the temperature of the print bed is too high, or insufficient cooling, or first layer may not cool properly. These are all the causes of elephant's foot. So in order to avoid that, this happens initially, because I also faced this kind of, I also experienced this kind of error initially, but I didn't know what to do. So while searching, I got this thing, elephant foot compensation. So first solution is leveling the print bed and adjust your nozzle. Okay. Next is bed temperature should be lowered initially, and afterwards you can increase bed temperature. Then print with a raft. Instead of brim and all, you print it with a raft, because raft will be taken care of that. Otherwise, you should give the chamfers to your model. Okay. So these are some of the difficulties or the basic thing you have to take care of while you are doing this software, Cura. Okay. I hope this thing is clear. Now we can move on to materials. Any doubts at this stage, you can please ask me.
No?
So someone has asked this thing, yeah. Sir, what is the solution if model doesn't stick it to the plate? I have answered that, it seems. I have answered that while showing, I have showed you this elephant foot compensation. That is what the solution. Next, any questions? I can answer you if I know. Otherwise I will move on to materials. Materials I will just show you, I am not going to bore you. Because materials, if I am starting on materials, please don't think that PLA is only material. There are so many materials. And it won't be that much interesting. That's why I selected. I actually planned for showing you materials first and afterwards go for the software. But later on I decided, in order to give you some idea on Cura. Otherwise it will be very boring. You might have gone. Okay. Then now I move on to this thing. So these are the list of materials. Don't think that this is exhaustive. So there are so many certain other materials, and they are, some materials are being developed. Even Altimaker is researching on these things. So first one, a crowd favorite, that is PLA. It is called as green plastic because everyone think that this material, since it is plastic, it is not eco-friendly. But this is actually cornstarch derivative. This PLA, PLA means polylactic acid, and it is, since it is an FDM, we are having, since FDM means fused deposition modeling, we are having these coils. I can show you afterwards these coils, and it's an easy material to 3D print, and even you can make food contact with this, because it can be used as any layers for storing food and all, no problem. So these are some of the distinct characteristics. It has low warping, can also be printed on cold surface. Then main thing is it is available in different colors, then 190 degree to 230 degree. Lower temperature than ABS. Other thing is PLA is, this is a shortcomings, PLA is less durable than ABS. ABS comes next. So PLA is less durable than ABS, and it is susceptible to heat. So higher engineering strength parts you should go for ABS. So this is next one, ABS. So you can see this, this is a functional printer that screw top. You can see. It's mainly, it's acrylonitrile butadiene styrene. It's used for bodyworks of cars, appliances, and mobile phone cases. And in addition to FDM, it can be used in SLS, SLA, PolyJet technologies, etc. You can see the temperature is more. Melting temperature or fusing temperature, that is 230 degree or 260 degree. So these are some of the distinct characteristics. This main point is it is non-biodegradable toxic material, and even compared to PLA, because PLA is green plastic, since it is cornstarch, and sometimes sugarcane and tapioca varieties can also be found. So it is degradable, but it is not biodegradable. Next one, this is ASA, acrylonitrile styrene acrylate. This is having good mechanical strength, even ultraviolet resistance, that is you can place it outside, that is what is given by UV, and even water resistance. So whatever you print using ASA, you can use it outdoor, outdoor application, that is what is given here, outdoor applications, and even in automobile industry. It has similar properties to ABS. But the problem is, you should keep it in a closed chamber, otherwise there is styrene emissions, that is toxic, okay. So every PLA, that the filament material should be kept inside a vacuum bags, vacuum container, okay. Otherwise, the problems like in between your filament may break because pores, etc. may occur. Next one is PET. There is polyethylene terephthalene. PET all knows, this is disposable plastic bottles. With this you can make suitable 3D printing material, and this is 100% recyclable. Even transparent, translucent filament you can make use of. And print, the temperature is less, 75 to 90 degrees Celsius you can print. And it also has good chemical resistance. This is one of the model. Now this is same as PET, but the thing is here glycolized polyester. That is glycol is added to reduce its brittleness and fragility. In order to reduce the brittleness and fragility, here some glycol is added to this PET, and this is also a good material. And it is amorphous plastic and can be 100% recycled. Can have this transparent filament using this. So next is polycarbonate. Polycarbonate is highly valued by additive manufacturing industry for its strength and transparency. It also should be kept in airtight containers. Temperature comes around 150 degrees Celsius. And since it is prone to absorbing moisture from the air, It also should be kept inside a bag or a vacuum bag. Otherwise, it can affect performance and printing resistance. And the main objective of this polycarbonate is can design optical parts, protective screens or decorative. This is actually the cover of the lens camera. You can see. So next, this is PEK, PEKK and ULTEM, that is high performance poly polymers. There are a family of this thing. I'm not going to read that. Polyethermites and problem is its characters, due to its characteristics, cannot be printed on all FDM machines. Okay. And since it needs 350 degrees Celsius. So normally a 3D printer machine, the general machine won't support this 350 degrees Celsius actually. But 65% of these materials are printed with FDM, the rest printed with SLS technology. And these are some of the parts made out of this thing. Next is polypropylene. It's also mainly used in the textile sector. And is resistant to abrasion. And then flexibility and rigidity. That are some of the characteristics of polypropylene. The drawbacks are its low temperature resistance and it is sensitive to UV rays, so it can't be used outside, outdoor applications. Next one, nylon. Nylon created from a fine white granular powder with SLS technology. It's also available in filaments for FDM. Next, it can be used in contact with food, but alcohol, it will react. So, as having good stability, rigidity, flexibility, and shock resistance. And it's high quality. It is used for this thing, aerospace market, automotive market, etc. And you can see this point, among FDM filaments, the layer bonding of nylon is stronger than all others, making it ideal 3D printing material for parts that require good tensile and mechanical strength. So this is a great point. It was for making materials having tensile and mechanical strength higher, then you should go for nylon. Next is composite materials. Composite materials, you all know, is lightweight. So the reinforcement, short fiber and continuous fiber are there. So these are actually, the composite means they are chopped fibers can be mixed with ABS or PLA. That's how it is made. Your base or matrix will be ABS or PLA. The composite matrix will be ABS or PLA and fibers can be chopped and kept inside. Carbon fibers can be used and even Kevlar or glass fibers can be used inside. And this is next metal composite. You can see the gold and silver can be used and the technique which are processed in powder form used in jewelry industry. DMLS, SLM, selective laser melting process. These are usually used for printing. Next, stainless steel, same. Next, titanium. This is a great invention done because titanium, you know, the knee, the ortho people, doctors are using to replace many of our internal parts with titanium metal, since titanium is strongest and lightest. And you can see this jaw, this titanium jaw. This is actually done by surgeons, successfully implanted. Your 3D printed jaw for a cancerous patient. And you can see here prosthetic legs also. Next, hybrid materials. 70% hybrid materials means 70% PLA. 70% PLA and 30% hybrid material. Then even wood based filaments can be used or mixed with PLA. And even metals like copper, bronze, etc. can also be incorporated. metal powders. This next, aluminide. This is mainly used in SLS process. Temperature resistance up to 172 degrees Celsius. And this post-processing treatment should be done. Post-processing means after you make the product, you should grind. You can grind some of the parts, or you can coat, or something like milling. Or milling, some part should be milled. So after this, you should post-process. So next material, this is a good one. That is soluble materials. Can see the soluble material. This is the actual part which is made, and it is put in the solution so that you got this way. Okay, so initially this is printed in a such a way that this is 3D printed object. It is put in a solution so that you got a spring like this. This is a bearing. This also, see, this is printed, and afterwards it is put in a solution. So after fully dissolved, you can see the bearing. So there are two common types of soluble filaments. One is HIPS, and next one is PVA. And HIPS means high impact polystyrene, which is associated with PLA, and it can be simply dissolved in water. That is a great characteristics of that, can be dissolved in water. So again, I given some of the specifications how to use this. This is PVA, polyvinyl alcohol. Now, this one is again flexible material. You can see the flexible material here. There's a newer type of filament, and this is the most successful. And here, this material is made of TPE, thermoplastic elastomer. And it is widely used in fashion industry. Okay. Next one is resins. So many resin characteristics, varieties are there. The first one is, this is based on polymerization, photopolymerization. That is when exposed to UV light, that part will be printed. This technique, the technology also include SLA, DLP, and digital light printing, and even material jetting, polyjet. And it has standard resin has properties similar to ABS, which has good, it has got good surface finish. And these are some of the examples. This is tough resin marketed by StoreCrunch. This is tough resins. They are marketed as ABS tough resins. Next, flexible resin. You can see this. This is, I already told, TPU, rubber-like material. Next to this one, plant-based, using soya beans, this type of material. Even you can see glow-in-dark resin. Material printed by the 3D printed material glows. Next, castable resin. That is for mainly, you can see rings, silver rings, etc., etc. Next material is ceramics. These are nowadays very useful in 3D printing. And this material is generally used in binder jetting technology, SLA and DLP. Next one is sandstone. They're also called as gypsum or multicolor. And protective coating of epoxy resin is added in order to enhance the color quality and strength. And it is mostly used by architectures, then prototypes and art projects. And this is another innovation, that is conductive filament. You can see the 3D printed below. This conductive filament, graphene combined with PLA. Combined with PLA, we can have conductive filament, which may be the next coming future. Next one, wax. Wax 3D prints, they are actually, it is having good application in dental area. Next, cobalt chromium, that is a super alloy, and it is having good strength and its temperature and corrosion resistance. Can use direct metal laser sintering, that is DMLS, and selective laser melting. Next one is Inconel, it's a super alloy. It can also be used as a 3D printing material in DMLS. Next, symbol paper, copy paper as a place in 3D printing. In the case of selective deposition lamination, is this paper 3D printing comes. And it is usually found with this thing, polyjet resins. And these are all about my section. I hope I give you some information on 3D printing and hope you understood everything. And if you have anything to ask me, you can ask. Thank you. Thank you. You can ask me any questions, okay? To my knowledge, I can.
Sir, this is Sandeep Raut, Professor yeah. Sandeep Raut from Pune.
Yeah.
I was trying to ask. I wanted to ask whether the aluminum that you have mentioned within the SLS system, right?
Yeah.
Can we use the same material when we are going to made it with a filament in FDM machines, that is fluid deposition modeling machine?
No, it seems it has to, because one thing is this temperature.
Just because of temperature, right?
Temperature. That is very difficult. We have metallic 3D printers. That will be of huge size. What I am telling is just FDM, that is domestic purpose only.
Okay. No, if we try to modify the extruder, if we are going to thermocoupling or the we can say the heating thing in an extruder and heating thing in the platform, can we achieve
that? Bed also you have to change, then extruder you have to move. Also the size of the printer will be more. In order to heat it, you should give some provisions.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir. That will be very useful.
Thank you. Yeah. And I can show you, if you didn't see this filaments, I can show you this. This is actually the filament. There is someone who didn't see, you can see this filament. And this is actually kept in a vacuum bag, which is this thing. This is fully sealed bag. You should keep it inside, otherwise what happens now, it will react with atmosphere and the moisture will be inside. Okay. And there are so many 3D printers now available, cheap rate. You can also assemble, or you can also make it. You can ask your students.
Sir, have you ever tried any food material for printing?
Yeah.
Have you ever tried for any food material?
No.
Because that is also emerging field.
Yeah.
Just want to know if any you have.
So I will share the PPT to Manisha. Okay. You want, you just go through. There are so many tutorials regarding to Cura, and even Cruise has developed one software for them. This is only Ultimaker. So many slicing softwares are available, but the only thing is about the designing for 3D printing. That is a great thing. Even I am not that much, I don't have that much knowledge on this designing part. That what we do is improvisation. Try. So many mistakes initially. So many mistakes. Okay, Manisha.
Sir, hello, sir. Completed, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Dear participant, any questions? Any clarification?
Some of them might have asked already. So.
I just wanted to tell you, sir, the session was very useful.
Hello?
Sir, I just wanted to tell that the session is very much useful for me, for my, from whatever research I'm doing over here.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, any other? Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Very much useful for all the participants and also myself. This is the last session for our program, session 14, different material use in 3D printing and slicing. Based on this session, you have delivered something about particular topic. So all the participants listen and understand something about this session. So once again, I thank for all participants and also today's keynote speaker, Mr. K. Sain, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, MES College of Engineering, Kerala. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Wonderful session for this.
Thanks for giving me a chance for this great session. Okay, thank you, sir.
All the participants, now unmute the video to take the photo session. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Thank you, sir. Dear